brought to you by Penguin.
Center Stage. Lessons from Actors on the Art of Charisma. Written and read by me, Jeannette Nelson. This is dedicated to the many, many actors and directors from whom I have learned my trade, and especially to the wonderful actors who contributed to this book. Introduction. I'll never forget the first time I saw Al Pacino rehearse a scene. It was 2004, and I was voice coach on the film of The Merchant of Venice, directed by Michael Radford, with Al playing the role of Shylock. From the moment he arrived in the rehearsal studio, he was in character. He wore black clothes, including a long black coat, and carried his body in a downward-leaning posture, his eyes mainly looking at the floor. But when he lifted them, he had the most penetrating gaze. Even in that first rehearsal, he was astonishingly powerful, and the young actors in the scene with him appeared almost paralysed by that power. I soon learned just how committed Al is to his work. When it came to filming, his intense energy, focus, creativity and stamina paid tribute to his training and his early career in theatre. He would ask for take after take of each of his scenes until he was satisfied he had offered up everything he could, resulting in a very human, complex and compelling portrayal of his character. This fascinating presence was not something that only emerged on screen, however. He had the same quality in real life. One evening, after rehearsals, he invited us to drinks at his apartment in New York. In that relaxed setting, at home with fellow professionals and friends, he was a charming host and as charismatic as he is on camera. Like many of the actors I have met, his personality wasn't forceful or dominating. It emerged from an understated self-confidence and self-reliance that made him very attractive. When I spoke to him, his attention seemed to be entirely on me. He was really listening to what I said. When you encounter very charismatic people like Al, it's tempting to assume that it's something that has come to them naturally, that some of us are simply better at holding people's attention than others. There might be some truth in that idea, but observing Al Pacino and other great actors makes you realise that their charisma, in performance and in person, often comes from their commitment to their work, the craft and art of acting. And it is a craft we can all learn from. This book is going to introduce you to some of the work I do with actors to help them communicate powerfully and charismatically. As a voice coach, my job is to help actors fulfill and maintain their potential as artists, who are, above all, communicators. I will share with you some of the advice I give to them and the exercises I use to get the best out of their voices, their bodies, and their scripts. Along the way, I will share some of their experiences with you. Experiences that they were kind enough to share with me in my research for this book. By introducing you to the methods that actors use to communicate effectively, my hope is that you too will glean insights into how to perform with charisma in your own life. Actors as artists. Working with actors is a privilege. Being part of the creative process of artists has led me to work on some of the most demanding stages in the world, everywhere from the National Theatre, the Royal Shakespeare Company, Shakespeare's Globe Theatre, Sydney Theatre Company, and in most of London's beautiful, iconic West End theatres, to school halls, warehouses, churches, and even the Houses of Parliament. In many cases, I have been lucky enough to work with an actor from the very beginning of their artistic journey at drama school, right through to the height of their profession. During this time, I have had the pleasure of working with some of our most talented actors, and as any teacher will tell you, working with people of great talent and ability always teaches the teacher as much as the student. I first understood how an actor can fill the National Theatre's Olivier stage by watching and listening to actors who have performed there for years. I have learned how to help actors with their vocal projection and clarity By working alongside those who began their careers in regional repertory theatres in the 1950s. I have seen how an actor can take an audience on a journey with clever, subtle shifts in their body language that draw the audience's attention to where they want it to go. Every day I see actors being so free and flexible with their bodies, voices and minds that you forget who they are. You only see and hear the character and the story being told. In a career spanning over 30 years, including 25 years at the National Theatre, my role has been to support actors from the first day of rehearsals to the day the play closes. During the 5 or 6 weeks of rehearsal, I work with them individually and in groups. My job in the early stages is to check in with how comfortable they are with their vocal technique and the demands of the play. We may do a voice workout using some of the exercises I will be sharing with you in this book, which will ensure they are heard clearly throughout the theatre. When I'm not working with the actors directly, I attend rehearsals to hear how their voice work is progressing, and equally importantly, I listen to what the director is asking them to do. Once the play begins preview performances, when we have evening audiences but are still rehearsing during the day, I lead pre-show voice warm-ups, and I attend performances to monitor the actors' audibility and clarity. After the press night, when the play has officially opened, I continue to lead regular warm-ups and keep my ear on the work by attending performances from time to time. I also work with actors on the language of the script, especially if it is a classical or political play. An important part of my career has been to study the work of great playwrights, from the timeless classical plays of ancient Greece and Rome, through medieval mystery plays, Shakespeare and his contemporaries, and the plays of the Restoration period, to the groundbreaking plays of Chekhov and Ibsen, and right up to the present. From these great writers, I have learned how stories in drama are told and how believable, truthful characters are formed. I have learned how language can be used, structured, and spoken in ways that change people, situations, and stories. From this study and my knowledge of the body and voice, I am able to work alongside actors and directors to support and develop the art they are making. My job is twofold. First, I keep the actors' voices in shape and up to the task of performing night after night in theatres big and small. Second, I help them to recognise and understand the way the play is written and to empower them to use the language in active and persuasive ways. This book will offer you insights from both sides of my job. From the exercises I use to help actors warm up their voices before they go on stage, and insights into how to feel in control in any room or on any stage, to the methods I use to help actors understand the most difficult scripts they are working with. In offering you these methods, my hope is that you will feel more confident performing in your own life. This book will be particularly helpful for anyone who is preparing to speak in front of a large group. Perhaps you're getting ready to give a best man speech, or have been working up to a crucial presentation in your job. Or maybe you need to deliver an important talk at a conference. In every case, this book will introduce you to exercises that will allow you to communicate clearly, confidently, and above all, charismatically. However, the insights I can impart are not limited to big set-piece speeches. You can also learn how to hold the room in a conversation by the water cooler, at a dinner party, or in the pub. You can learn to feel more confident and comfortable socially by becoming aware of how your body and voice work, by listening to others more effectively, and by becoming aware of the give and take of conversation, debate, and argument. You can learn to use your voice more expressively as you read a bedtime story to your children or your grandchildren, or share your views with your book club or study group. Charismatic communication is useful in every setting. What is charisma? What is it that gives a person charisma? We recognize it when we see it. Many actors exude it. It is that quality that draws us to somebody, that makes us want to listen to them and to be around them. It is a quality that can hold an audience, from the stage and in the boardroom, on the screen and in the office, at a party and at dinner. It is also a quality that can be learned. Having trained young actors and then worked with them in professional theatre, I have seen them metamorphose from awkward teenagers to lovely, genuine, charismatic people, not just when they perform, but in real life too. Most, though not all, actors train in drama school when they are in their late teens and early 20s. While there, they explore...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.